Call-A-Ride is the newest option for rideshare in the Tampa Bay area. And we're here with two of the members from their team today, Jeremy King, Michelle Yeager. And everyone seems like they're pretty familiar now with rideshare services, right? There are already some big players in the game. So let's get right down to it. How are you different? Welcome to the show. We're excited to have you
guys. Thank you so much. We're excited to be here and to be able to tell Tampa Bay about Call-A-Ride.
Yeah,
so we like to say the world didn't need another rideshare, but it did need a better one.
Oh.
And we've taken rideshare and we looked at all the problems that are happening with riders, with drivers, and we said, how can we fix this and make it a better experience for everybody? So, I mean, if you look at the average experience of a driver, you log in, you go drive somewhere, and you wait for a random ping. You get that ping, you pick somebody up. You're not controlling how much that person is charged. You're not controlling how much you make. You don't even know what percentage of the fare you're getting a lot of the time.
Really?
And no matter how good of experience that rider has, you're probably never gonna see him again. So you can't grow your business. So, you know, with Call-A-Ride, we really believe it's your vehicle, your gas, your time. You should be able to control your business and your money. And for riders, you know, we don't even think about it anymore, but like surge pricing, you go somewhere and it costs you $7, you try to get home and it's $40.
Yes.
That's probably like one of my biggest pet peeves with rideshare. And you know, there's no personalization, there's no customization. You don't control anything. You push a button, they send you whatever random rider that they want to, or whatever random driver they want to send you. And you know, so we want to fix the experience for riders and drivers. You know, we like to say it's more of a, it's more than rideshare, it's a ride service.
Well, so let's kind of, you expressed too very well how the drivers changed and touched on how it's a little different for riders. I think as females too, we always feel that like, you know, there's a safety component. We want to make sure we have control over it. How have you seen Call-A-Ride being different from those other rideshare services?
It's completely different. It starts with being able to select actually who's picking you up. Right now you have no choice with other rideshare services. You just simply put in your location, they send you who they send you, and it tells you, but it's too late, right? They're already on their way.
Yes.
This way with Call-A-Ride, you actually get to choose. So you can read profiles, you can see when their safety checks were done, you can read reviews that other people have left that are you know, there for everybody to see. But most importantly, you know, you have total control over who's going to come pick you up. And for women, it's wonderful because you can choose if you want a female driver. Like, let's say you're riding, you know, alone at night.
Which I rarely do for this factor, to be quite honest.
Maybe not at night, but maybe any other time. You just want to feel safe.
Absolutely.
You can request somebody by gender, so you can request a female driver. And if you're traveling with your pet, you can request that as well. And another great feature is, let's say you speak, you know, you're new to town and you don't speak English very well.
Yes.
You can actually search for the language that the drivers speak.
Again, you're making it more personalized.
Absolutely.
It seems, to make sure that everybody's experience is just a little bit better.
Yep.
You touched on too for drivers how they can really customize their own business plan. How is that possible? We just kind of glossed over before, so I'm curious if there are people out there that are interested in becoming a driver.
Right. So right now, like I said, drivers really have no control over their business. So we want to make drivers into entrepreneurs, right? We want them to grow their business and have control over that. So the first thing that we start with is drivers can actually set their own hourly rate.
Wow.
It's your time, you know, you decide how much you should be making when you're out driving. So let's say you set your rate at $40 an hour, you do a 30-minute ride, you know that you're gonna get $20. There's nobody, you know, sticking their fingers in that, trying to pull money out from you.
Yeah.
And then the rider just pays a couple rideshare fees on top of that. It's all clear, concise, and, you know, basically transparent for everybody. And then we give them their own website, their own profile page, and their own referral code that they can pick. So like I pick Car Guy. Now I can hand out cards. If people sign up under me and they put Car Guy in, I will automatically be put on their favorites list. So everything we do is based around them deciding how to run their business and being able to grow an actual client base. And then at the end of every ride, riders can actually favorite you as a driver. So if they had a great experience and they're like, man, I'd love to use you again, well, now you can. And so that's another way that they grow their client base. And now,
I like how you say if you enjoy that ride, then they can, of course, come back. I think we should say the same thing for both of you guys. I feel like we're just lost in the service. Let's come back, talk about this a little bit more. And I know right now, if you have questions, this is a good time to call. There's a special offer right there. All the information is on your screen, so you can find out more about Call-A-Ride today.